20 tests on one day. India, England, Australia. What a play!
Warm welcome, everyone. Cricket season is in full swing. India England series, Pakistan South Africa, Bangladesh West Indies, and New Zealand Australia season is starting. We had IPL auction, which just went by, created a lot of buzz amongst everybody globally. While all this is happening, you must have seen or heard news that Ishan Kishan lights up opening day of Vijay Hazare Trophy. 173 run knock in 94 balls. It's a 50 over tournament. And Jharkhand, the team he plays for, posted 422 runs. That is crazy. Highest total in the history of tournament. So what is Vijay Hazare Trophy? Facts, format. Mithun and Sanjay will talk to us all about it today. Welcome, guys.
Hi, Sanjay.
Starting, first things first, what is Vijay Hazare Trophy?
So for our young viewers, Vijay Samuel Hazare is absolute legend of Indian cricket in the years gone by. He was the first batsman to score a 100 in first-class circuit. He was the first player to score a century in three matches in a row. Over 50 centuries throughout his first-class career. He took India to the first ever win in 51-52 against England at Madras. All in all, you know, classy right-hand batsman and a useful right-arm medium pacer. He played 30 matches and 258 first-class games. And he was also the first batsman to score a century in both the innings of a test match. So from a tournament perspective, Vijay Hazare, you may feel that it's a low-key tournament, especially when international cricket is going around. But remember, this year, there is no Ranji Trophy. Any test match, you know, places may go to guys who are in form, who do well in Vijay Hazare Trophy. Considering how we picked up some T20 guys who were as a backup in Australia, this could be exceedingly important for anyone who's participating in the tournament.
So the Vijay Hazare Trophy, the 19th edition of the tournament started on 20th of February 2021 in India. So the format of the tournament is that 38 teams are divided among elite and the plate group. So elite group is consisting of five groups of six teams, and then eight teams are in the plate group. So the last year champions Karnataka placed in Group C along with Uttar Pradesh and Kerala, the formidable teams. So the tournament is going to be a good platform for all the Indian youngsters who are trying to make a mark for themselves in the Indian cricket. And also looking at the Indian cricket since 2000 onwards, the importance of domestic cricket has increased, and all the players, whoever is not playing the international cricket at the current time, will definitely be featuring in these tournaments, because they have to prove their match fitness and get into the Indian team. So it's not easy for the players to get into the Indian team after they're coming through the injuries, especially. So they have to come and play these tournaments to prove themselves their match fit. And then all the players who are seasoned in IPL as well as Indian cricket, like Bhuvaneshwar Kumar, Dinesh Karthik, and Sanju Samson, Robin Uthappa, all these players are featuring in this tournament.
Yeah, and I noticed that the tournament started in 2002 and 2003. I'm more familiar with the Challenger Trophy, which used to be played between India A, India B, and India C, if I'm not wrong, or seniors, juniors. This is more or less, like Sanjay mentioned, an equivalent or a replacement for Ranji, because this season Ranji tournament wasn't played. So all stakes on board for the youngsters to step up. Elite and plate, what is the difference, Mithun?
My understanding is that the elite and plate group are done based on the points what each team earns during the calendar year across all the formats of the games. It might be under-19s or under-22s in the Ranji Trophy level, as well as the Syed Mustaq Ali and Vijay Hazare. So all the team points are combined together, earned the required criteria of points will be moved to the plate group. And similar way, the teams which have played really well in the plates get promoted to the elite.
And in terms of the format, just to make people understand how this will work, because there are so many different groups. So you've got the five elite groups. So five top teams from each team, from each group, straight away go through the quarterfinals. Then within this five elite group, you have top three teams based on the points after the winners of the group will also go to the quarterfinals. Just that the last team based on the points, the eighth team, gets a chance to play with the top team of the played group. So even the played group, someone's got a chance to make it to the quarterfinals. So there's a playoff between the top team of the played group and the bottom team based on the points across the five elite groups. So then everyone goes into a quarterfinal. In terms of the dates, so you will see the group stages finishing 1st of March and then the knockouts between 7 to 14. One thing, if you follow the Vijay Hazare, you will realize that the players are playing actually for their home team or the home state. So the likes of, say, Ishan Kishan playing for Mumbai, but he'll be playing for Jharkhand. Someone like Krunal Pandey would be playing for Baroda. So it would be different if you are looking at them and you're trying to say, oh, where's my Mumbai player? Where's my Bangalore player? But they would truly be representing their local team from where they've come.
It's not all about franchisee cricket. It gives opportunity for local cricketers to prove talent. And we've seen the importance of it. The timing of Syed Mushtaq Ali, I think you guys covered it in the previous episode, was excellently done in prior to IPL auction. Like some Mohammad Azharuddin, Hasan Zakaria, when they did Syed Mushtaq Ali well, got chances to IPL.
Just one more point, and this is basically, if you were to very simply put it, this is basically a one-day tournament of Ranji. So, and this is excellent opportunity for all the international players, all the known players who've made their name, to go back to their states and give something back, give the experience back, you know, and share that knowledge amongst the group. Because franchise cricket, international cricket, it pays you well, all the limelight and everything is there. But here it's really important for them to take time out when no one's watching. There's hardly much coverage for a lot of the games.
Yeah, definitely important thing about the domestic cricket now. After IPL, the Indian domestic cricket has increased and the importance of the games have improved. So basically, you need to understand that not everyone can go ahead and play for India. So so maybe making a name for themselves through the domestic cricket, they can earn a place for themselves in the IPL franchise, which will definitely help them both financial aspects as well as for making a name for themselves in cricket.
Who are some of the players to watch out for?
Like lights of Ishan Kishan, Surya Kumar Yadav, Dinesh Karthik, Jagdishan, a wicketkeeper batsman from Tamil Nadu, and Robin Uthappa, the veteran batsman, and then Sachin Bedi, the captain of Kerala team. So these are the players who would like to make a name for themselves and definitely be itching to perform.
For a lot of the players, this would be the only thing they play for this year. So it will be absolutely crucial. And you know, you feel sad for them that you know, they've not had much cricket. And if you're not in part of the international circuit or IPL, then or Syed Mushtaq Ali tournament for some of them, this is the chance for them to perform and shine.
Excellent. So this has been great. Hopefully our viewers will find this snippet absolutely useful because I learned a lot hearing you guys about Vijay Hazare Trophy. Thanks Mithun and Sanjay, as usual. Appreciate it. A lot of knowledge which comes out of both of you, and we will chat with you guys later on another topic. Thanks very much.